Just because I ride your face at night doesn't mean you should cast me aside. This is important business.
Mama, don't go to background, find this. Mama, don't you say I'll be good, boy.
Hi guys, welcome back to a Wacko's Review, the only reviewer that is black. You can do your best. Check it online. I'm the only black reviewer out there. So guys, I finally opened a Patreon account after a friend of mine forced me to do so. And the reason why I opened it was so I can get a new computer because I am currently using a rock to edit my videos. So if you want to help, the link to the Patreon is in the description. And also stick to the end of this video to get more details or to hear more stories on why I need a new computer. All right. Okay. Roll intro. I won't lie, because of TMC, I've been attacked by so many people. And before, I thought it was just because of my love for Jasmine. But now it has changed. Everyone hates me because they feel I fabricate the review and I add scenes that do not exist. And to be honest, I have never felt so bad. I have never felt so insulted. I am a credible reviewer. I will never fabricate information. It's not like the name of the channel is a Wacko's Review. Eh? Eh? You get the joke, eh? 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 But as usual, you know how we do it here. We take the characters one by one and tell you what happened to them. So firstly, we start with Tayo, the man, the myth. I've used this joke before. I'm running out of jokes, literally. Tayo is depressed because of his account, obviously. He's also heartbroken that Tiara left him, and this is bad because he sees her everywhere. You step into his house, Tiara! Tiara, is that you? You use his toilet in his house. Tiara! Tiara, is that you? I'm very familiar with that smell. He's worried that Tiara will go back to the life of drugs because he's egotistic. You know, it's only someone that has so much ego that would think their ex would do drugs because they broke up with them. And she will probably do drugs, but it's still egotistical. But since Larry did not have any major screen time in this episode, TMC did their very best to make him carry over his stupidity by asking this question.
Which do you care about most?
What type of question was that? Do you expect him to say yes, the money, eh? Even if it's the money, do you still expect him to say that? Then Tiara's dad came into Tayo's house, and you can only wonder, does anyone on the island lock their doors? Like, come on, at least lock your gates. But Tiara's dad was initially smiling, and I was not shocked. I'm not going to lie. You trust that he would be the last person to know about his daughter's disappearance. Then after Tayo told him about everything that transpired in his scared tone and he was stammering a lot, I was confused. Tiara's dad then did what he knows best, which is to allow people do the very thing he lacks in, and that is parenting. He then left all the work to Tayo, and if that's not enough, he also called him a huge disappointment for not taking good care of his daughter. My good sir, you are the disappointment if you do not know. The next time we see Tiara, she was doing what every Nollywood movie made in 2007 depicted bad girls to be, like smoking and taking cocaine like this. But Tayo saw her, and after almost pushing this guy off the set, he then took her away. Oh, she fainted. That's when the smoke and the cocaine enters. I know all these things. I used to club in 2007. Let me say 2007. For Louis, he's tired of sleeping in the guest room, so he came back wanting to sleep in the bed he bought. But he had to talk to his mom first because that was the only way she would allow him sleep on the bed that he bought. They said a lot here, but what caught my fancy was when she spoke about sex, saying Louis is a sex slave and she won't allow him to sleep with her because she doesn't love him. You guys are wondering, where did all this happen? I don't know. Some people said I was fabricating information. I don't know where they found that from. I don't know. I'm walking away from... Oh, sorry, I'm still reviewing the show. He saw his mom, told her that he called their lawyer and recorded the call in case he wanted to try and do any fabu. But this was not the bread and butter of the conversation because his mom told him Tonya wants everything he owns. She wants his house. She wants his hotel. She wants his penny. I can't say that on YouTube. And as his mom was telling him the gospel truth, Louis was trying his best to win the love of his female fans, as all he did here was act like how every lady thinks their man is talking about them behind closed doors.
She's the love of my life. She makes my heart do boom, 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 boom.
Ha! Get away from here. No one's talking like that. The two policemen from the last time Louis was taken to the station came and took Louis's mom for questioning because of fraud. Yep. Take away. I never liked her. Tony then came with some thugs to take over their home, but she had to fight Lola and her. I can't even call this guy a thug. After Lola argued like she owned the house, her husband-to-be then told her that, oh, don't do that, oh. It's her house now. Go back. Go and pack. Sharp. Leave. But this thing here would pain anyone, but I commend how Lola took it. She literally took it with her chest. You get? Her chest. Because her phone touched it. I am funny. You guys are not the funny one yet. Shalua is pissed that Minu did not show up for their arranged dinner with her mom, and it's sad that he doesn't notice her beauty. And I don't blame him, because I found out that Aminu is actually possessed. Yes, guys, yes. I read the script. He's possessed by Mystique. Trust me, I'm not saying all these things to deceive you guys. That's the last thing I'm gonna do. Deceive you guys. He then got a call from his investigator, and this call was just someone telling him about that guy that Misty cheated on him with. What's his name? Clint. If you remove the C from his name, you have Lint. Today is not my day. I'm not going to lie. And this part here worried me, because Aminu only spoke on how unhappy he was and how he has longed and he missed Misty. And as he was saying all those things, all I could hear was that Nollywood effect, and my eyes were like, where is Patience Uzoko going to pop out from? Then after he left my queen, he went to his office, then Patrick came to warn Aminu, but Patrick made a fatal mistake, and that mistake was he forgot when it's 5 p.m, Aminu locks his brain up, and nothing you would say can ever enter his skull. Then Patrick went to meet Jasmine, who was worried that they would be caught, and as everyone was scared, Jasmine's mom then called my queen, promise. And you can see Patrick laugh, because he noticed that Jasmine's mom was mad. But with everyone leaving Jazoo, all I can say is, my queen, don't worry. I'll be there to save you from all these evil people around you. Why am I talking like that? And that's it, guys. That's all that happened in this. Oh. Those people. If I don't talk about them now, the same prince has been fabricating all these things. Okay, so Misty gave a bag with his bank documents. Skip that one. No one cares. He then proceeded to tell her about his failure. Skip that part, no one cares. She almost cried at the skip that part, no one cares. They kissed, skip that part, no one cares. My goodness, oh my goodness, this show doesn't need these people. I'm not gonna lie. Then after that shiny bang bang, Aminu did something that I have seen him do before, and I feel we all noticed it, but we never made it a problem till now. He is a misogynistic pipe. Think about it. He never wants her to walk. And every girl needs that freedom to work and make their own money. He's bad for the show. Cancel him. He's misogynistic. He is. Guys, stand up tall. Cancel him. Is this thing working? This is not working. By the end of the episode, Clint was caught. These two are still going strong and everyone loves them. Oh, cutie. So yeah, what are your expectations? For me, I want this relationship to end. My goodness, please, that's all I want. That's all my expectations. It's not even an expectation, it's a wish. Please spoil this relationship. Amen. Thank you guys for watching. Shout out to my friend Victoria. I wanted to call her Veronica now. Why did I want to call her Veronica? Shout out to my friend Victoria. She was able to force me to make the Patreon account, and why I created it was because, see, I'm literally using an iron to edit. I'm not lying. It is fast, but the issue is it's not mine, and I need to get another one. But yo, that thing is expensive. So I would love for you to help me fund my dream, so I'll make more videos for you guys, but only for the people who have enough to spare. I don't want anybody that is struggling or finding it hard this period to say, I'm not insensitive. I don't know why I'm even adding that part. Obviously, you know I'm not insensitive. So please, it would be lovely if you helped out, if you can. The link to the Patreon is down in the description. Yeah. Thank you guys for watching this video. I'm literally sweating. I'm not going to waste your time. I've been recording for 18 minutes. The video will probably be 8 minutes long. What happened in the 10 minutes that you missed? No one would know. Thank you guys for watching. We'll catch yourself on the next one. Bye.